iBots team. Our project is K-Cycler, a smart paper collection and recycling system. Here's our team. Neha, Aryan, Skanda, Om, Sanjana, and I'm Sanjana too. Here's our presentation.
Wait a minute, Aryan, did you know that over 20 billion K-cups are ending up in landfills and not decomposing, and you just added one more? Trash from over 1 year's worth of K-cups can circle the Earth almost 12 times. Although our team looked at other potential problems like batteries, food scraps, styrofoam cups, and plastic bags, we were alarmed by the magnitude of the problem posed by single-serve K-cups. Believe it or not, in addition to coffee and tea, there will even be K-cups for sodas and soups, making the environmental problem even worse. That is exactly why the Cybots have chosen to address this problem. Sanjana will now present our innovative solution.
Sure, let me walk you through our approach to this problem. We realize that there are two aspects to this problem. The first one is, how can we collect millions and millions of K-cups from homes and businesses that otherwise would end up in landfills? And two, how can we process large volumes of K-cups into individual recyclable components? Before we present our innovative solution, let me tell you the ideas that inspired us. As you may know, in some states, people can deposit used cans and plastic bottles and get instant credit for their deposits. We draw from this to collect used K-cups through vending machines. Also, there's a handheld tool called a recycling cup, which separates plastics from used K-cups. This process is manual and very slow. We expand on this to make a recycling plant that can process large volumes of K-cups. Now, Sanjana and Neha will present our solution.
Cybots will provide K-cup collection bins in offices, businesses, and households to store used K-cups in and avoid throwing them into trash. As shown in the model here, Cybots will install K-cup deposit machines in all major grocery stores, malls, and even universities where people frequently visit. People and businesses can conveniently deposit their K-cup for instant store credit or cash from the vending machine. Cybot trucks will collect all the K-cups from the deposit machines and ship them to our plant where volumes of K-cups will be processed and separated into their main components. Now Neha will show us how the processing plant works.
After the K-cups have been brought to our recycling machine, we now have to separate the four components: coffee, plastic, paper, and aluminum foil. As you can see, the conveyor belt holds the K-cup from the top. There are three stations to our model. In the first station, this rotating blade will cut the plastic so it will fall into the next bin. In the second station, the coffee and the paper will be cut because of the second rotating blade. It'll fall into the next bin. This bin is different though. It's like a filter. When a jet of air and water blow, it'll blow the paper to a different bin while the coffee stays in the first. In the last station, the aluminum foil will fall into the last bin. Now Om will show how this project makes money.
As shown here, we sell each of the individual components to the respective manufacturer. Plastic will go to plastic manufacturers, the coffee grounds will go to fertilizer manufacturers, the paper filter will go to paper manufacturers, while the aluminum foil would be raw material for other aluminum products. One thing that's so fascinating about this model is that while it's still such an immense problem, it's economically viable. Here's how it works. We understand in order to make this a viable model, we have to encourage and reward our customers, and we do just that by giving back 1 cent for every one K-cup that is deposited. And that's not all. We would be selling each of the individual components, and this would give us a total revenue of $10 million. Now, by giving back 1 cent, our total cost would be $4 million. So now, Aryan will tell you who we shared with.
We shared our idea with other people because we wanted them to know that K-cups could get recycled, and we wanted to get some ideas from them. My teammate Sanju talked to Lieutenant Governor Boyd Rutherford about our innovative solution. He was amazed and advised to share with the Department of Environment. Om and Skanda have talked to their teachers and office staff members in their school about our project. They were also very impressed. This bag shows the amount of K-Cups consumed by 3 office staff members in Omens Gunda School in a single day. Now imagine if 1 billion people consumed this many K-Cups, and about a landfill could end up looking like this. As you can see, this is a huge problem. We are excited that our solution addresses this problem to save our planet from pollution.
Save planet Earth!
Sorry, some questions here. Okay, so
I see your list of sources over there. So, and they're back here. So, do you have any sources other than internet sources and personal experience?
Actually, yes. We talked to professionals. We talked to a scientist at the National Institute of Standards and Technology. We also use books, magazines, and like I said, and like stated here, we use websites.
To add on to that, we also we did extensive research on the Keurig website and Green Mountain as the top producers of K-Cups. So we did extensive research on over 30 websites, searching through how we can.
So what did you learn from your interview with the scientist from this?
Actually, we all interviewed, yeah. And we learned that multiple K-Cups can't be recycled the way they are right now, but once separated, they can be recycled, and that's what led to this whole project.
So you talked a lot of business, but that like a very complete idea, but you guys are aiming big, but like how would you start? Would it be one factory to start, or would you have more than one or multiple?
We're still running some numbers, and what we're thinking is that we still need to, you know, get we still need to depend on like how many factories per state, how many factories per county. Still need to run some numbers, but currently this is just a prototype. Just brought to show you.
So did you talk with anyone in manufacturing or like robotics or advice for that, or was that just like you guys came up with the design by yourself?
Well, we came up with it as a team, and we wanted to solve an immense problem for this because there's only, like Sanjana said, it's just a manual K-cup recycling cup. But there are other solutions. Like in Michigan, where I used to grow up, I used to enjoy depositing like plastic bottles and cans into machines, and we get rewards for that. So we grew from that solution.
And to add to that, she said that there were other solutions out there. Well, the other, like recycle a cup, it's manual, so it takes a lot of time. This is automated, so you can get it done. You can get process large volumes of K-cups even quicker.
So what would be the exact size? This is a prototype. Would it be about this size and just multiple ones, or be like a larger machine?
Well, it would be this size.
We
would have
what would be, I guess, the scope of your starting? Would it just kind of maybe be around the university or the area?
Well, as you can see, it is in this is like a little model of how we can, where we can put them. And we can put them in malls, even hotels where people can recycle, as well as neighborhoods.
Okay. I know, college students like to get a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And
offices.
And curators are all throughout.
Yeah. Yeah,
we put
one
machine
at
UBC.
Yeah.
Yeah.
University.
Oh,
yeah, UBC.
Oh.
So, I guess.
So you mentioned about how you share your list with the Lieutenant Governor and then the Department of Environment. What was the reply to your idea? Are they thinking about implementing it maybe? Or?
Well, he never really, well, I met him when I was, because I do pageants, and we met, went to meet him. So I talked to him, and he never knew these K-cups could be recycled because he drinks coffee a lot, and he just throws them away. So he was amazed and advised, as RN said, that to share with the Department of Government, because that he wants to start doing this. He's excited about it.
That is tough. Thank you guys for your presentation. Good luck on the rest of the day.
Thank you.